We arrived in the morning after two nights on the way and 2 days without get something to drink, without food. Opened the doors and we saw crazy people in pajamas, stripes, white and blue stripes. And they shout to us, fast, fast, fast. Suddenly, in this rush, forward, I saw in my eye the fence, barbed wires. So it was a very big shock. Men to the left, women to the right. I thought to my mother, we will see each other inside. It was the last time I saw my sisters and my mother.
Leon Weintraub tem hoje 89 anos. Tinha 17 quando foi deportado para Auschwitz. Não chegou a ter um número tatuado na pele, porque Leon estava no bloco onde todos os prisioneiros seguiam diretamente para as câmaras de gás. 4 semanas depois de chegar ao campo, conseguiu fugir.
I saw between the block 16, 18, a group of naked men. I was very shy, but finally I dared to ask, what are you doing here? Nah, naked. Yes, we have been registered and we are waiting for clothes. We shall go out for work. And this word out was a signal. I got the impulse, looked on the left, to the right, no SS, looked around, nobody looked me, out my 3 clothes and in this group, mixed up with them.
Leon esteve em 4 campos de concentração alemães. Foi resgatado pelo exército francês a 23 de abril de 45. Pesava 35 quilos, sofria de tifo. Depois de uma carreira médica na Suécia, este judeu polaco dedica a reforma a explicar ao mundo os horrores do regime nazi.
While you were there, did you know that people were being killed in the gas chambers?
No. Around the clock, this dark, heavy, so terrible smelling for burnt flesh, this smoke was going to all of smelling burnt flesh, everything. This was something what was terrible for me.
Do you ask yourself, why did I survive and the others not?
In my case, personally, it was this impulsive, this few steps, because a few days later, this block number 10, the youngster block, was taken to the gas chamber and all have been killed. And I am an optimist. I am a chronic, incurable optimist, because when I went all of this, through this, and survived, what could happen to me?
Sandra Sacotti, David Araújo, RTP, Auschwitz, Polónia.